ZincOx Resources have just announced their full year figures. Now, ZincOx, in case you didn't know, is running a very innovative and, in fact, one of the largest zinc recycling plants in the world, in Korea. Some figures on that. It's designed to treat 200,000 tonnes per annum of hazardous waste created by the recycling of scrap and extracting from that about 50,000 TPA of zinc as an oxide concentrate. And this, in terms of a mine, makes it about the size of a medium-sized zinc mine. Well, we're joined now by the CEO, Andrew Woollett. I think it's just fascinating what you're doing in terms of technology in Korea. But looking at the figures, it does seem that you've made quite a substantial loss. Why?
Yeah, indeed. 2014, we are posting a large loss. About 40% of that is an impairment we've made on an asset we bought some years ago in America, which is no longer part of our core strategy. So it's really just prudent, if you like, to financially impair that. When you look at the underlying results, which is all about the project itself, that's really much more important. And there we've turned around the situation substantially. Revenues are up 38%, $39 million. And it's really been a turnaround year for the company.
So what about when are you going to start making money? When is it going to start coming through at the operating level?
Well, we're actually making money at the moment at the operating level. Now, in 2013, we made a loss of $9 million, and that reduced last year to $1.3 million. In fact, in the first half of last year, there was a loss of $1.4 million, and in the second half, we posted a slight profit. Then in the first quarter of 2015, we've already made an operating profit of $750,000, and we expect that in the next quarter to be significantly better. So it really has been a turnaround year for the company.
Now, if you look at some of the problems that you've faced, I mean, you've got this very innovative technology, which is getting pretty close to, if not actually achieving, 100% recycling of the waste and extracting it from the waste. Nevertheless, there have been some technical problems along the way. Now, you're saying we're reaching a turning point. How can you guarantee that?
Yeah, look, it's been a very long and rocky road getting this plant wrapped up to full capacity. The interesting thing is that the bulk of the problems over the last 18 months have not been to do with the core technology at all, but to do with peripheral equipment. And this is in the heat exchangers, which recover energy from the process. And we had tremendous corrosion problems on those. We've sorted that now by lining the heat exchangers with a refractory, and this gives us about a four-month period between maintenance stoppages, which still allows us to operate the plant profitably overall. So that's really been a big change we made. We installed that modification in August, and since then we've had fewer stoppages and basically more months making a positive contribution to EBITDA. In fact, over the last 7 months, we've only had two negative months.
So you've just done a debt restructuring. Some people might suggest that 9.5% is a bit expensive.
Yes, the original debt we set up with Korea Zinc had two parts to it, $37 million of long-term debt at 5% of a LIBOR, so incredibly cheap for a company of our size. And then it had a sort of mezzanine finance in at 15% interest. And what we have restructured recently with Korea Zinc is to roll up some accrued interest into the development loan, which was $15 million. And it was due for repayment in February next year. Now, we knew that because of the slow ramp-up, we wouldn't have generated enough cash from the project to pay that amount down in February. So what we've negotiated is to spread those payments over six equal installments, starting in February, and then paying every 6 months another installment. So that means we're going to be able to meet these commitments out of cash flow. And the other thing is they agreed to bring down the interest rate from 15 to 9.5. And although that sounds quite a lot, the weighted average cost of our debt is only 6.2% interest, which is, you know, unbelievably good, certainly better we can get from a commercial lender.
So what plans have you got for the year ahead?
Well, the first priority remains Korea. And there we are going to optimise the process. That means we'll move from sort of where we are at the moment, which is about 95% recovery and 95% throughput, up to full targeted throughput and recovery. And at the same time, debottleneck the plant. So while the heat exchangers, we have a solution to it, it's not perfect. And what we want to do is really take out the heat exchangers completely, and then we'll be able to operate at 200,000 tonnes a year. So that's sort of KRP, and then of course we're very excited about the new projects.
You say a new project, one can't help thinking, well, maybe you should wait till everything's settled down with KRP, and then you know a new project might be a bit premature.
No, I don't think so. I mean, the core process has now been demonstrated beyond any shadow of doubt. So when we design the new plant, we'll have a different heat recovery system, and we won't have the problems that we've experienced at KRP. What has been important is to demonstrate the quality of the products, because we produce intermediate products for zinc and for iron. And in the new projects, we're going to make those into final products. This is particularly important in the case of zinc, where we move from a zinc intermediate concentrate, which we sell to a smelter who makes zinc metal, into directly into a zinc oxide of chemical grade, which we can sell in the marketplace to various end users. And the important thing about that is that the zinc oxide chemical sells for twice the zinc oxide concentrate. So we can double the revenue from a new plant at a relatively small additional cost. So the new plants will have a complete recycling of iron to zinc to final product. So we call it the full cycle approach. And this typically generates internal rates of return of around 25% ungeared. So it's a very strong project.
But are those predictions based on what the current price of zinc, or you know, what's your view about where it's going? Is it still economical?
Yeah, look, we use 2250 as a long term for zinc. It's 2150 at the moment. Everybody's aware of shortages next year and over the next couple of years. So we think that's going to strengthen, if anything. But we tend to just use 2250 flat. We think that's a reasonable price going forward.
Right. Okay. Well, thank you very much indeed. Andrew Woollett for joining us.
Thank you.